The legend says that the temple of Banteay Chhmar appeared by magic. An ancient king who had seven wives was devastated because none of them could give him children. So the king asked Buddha to reincarnate a devotee god by impregnating the seventh wife. When the child came to the world, the six other wives took revenge by banishing the mother and the child, who had to escape to the forest. The mother died shortly after, but the son of the king survived thanks to the assistance of a splendid young woman who brought him succulent dishes by taking the appearance of a cat. One day, the son of the king took the skin of the cat to prevent the girl from leaving. She explained to him how he could become a king. He had to put the skin of the cat in the place where he wanted to have his castle. Both of them fell in love, and in the early morning, the young king put the skin of the cat close to his refuge, and the fortress appeared by magic. The young king was so amazed that his first words were to baptize this temple, Banteay Chhmar, the fortress of the cat. Today, there is not much left of the multitude of sculptures and engravings which decorated the enclosures and buildings of the temple. However, the wild aspect of the site, the roots which marry the stones, and the absence of mass tourism give a fascinating aspect to the temple. In spite of the decay of the site, the tourist potential of this place seems undeniable. The few hikers questioned on their visit stated to be happy to have been able to discover authentic Kampuchea far away from traditional routes.
Une autre piste d'action qui a été envisagée, c'est de développer le tourisme, un tourisme solidaire à Banteay Chhmar.
Another considered project was to develop tourism in Banteay Chhmar area, always with the idea to generate a plus income for the villagers of Banteay Chhmar. Then, it could be possible to create a local development fund that would be fed by the benefit drawn from tourism, and then reinvested in projects for the commune of Banteay Chhmar. This aspect is very new. APLC operates much more in the province of Odar Manjay, and thus it is a new activities orientation. That it is very new, and this is quite the main reason of my presence. I have to evaluate what is possible with local development within the commune of Banteay Chhmar.
C'est un peu l'objectif de ma présence ici, et de voir qu'est-ce qu'on peut faire en termes de développement local au sein de la commune de Banteay Chhmar.
And then, with much good mood, Alban interviews the villagers of Banteay Chhmar. Villagers did appreciate the Day of the Temple, organized by Agir Paulet Cambodge, in June 2006. For this opportunity, Agir succeeded to mobilize the children of the village to clean the 5 hectares of surface of the temple. It was a simple but effective event. Besides this, it was useful to alert the young people about the necessary preservation of ancient ruins. The temple is an incredible vestige of the prestigious past of the Khmer civilization, but also a life source for the villagers. The supply of drinking water comes primarily from the rainwater which feeds the broad ditches of the fortress. The fortress has a cultural and also a vital importance, and Agir does not want to abandon the fortress because of this. The temple has ditches located very close to a high-coloured market which proposes true regional curiosities that APLC also wishes to rehabilitate.
Une des pistes d'action qui a été proposée par le précédent volontaire était d'assainir le marché. Quand on se promène sur le marché, on voit qu'il y a un réel besoin au niveau assainissement.
Another form of project was to clean the market. When you walk inside the market, you can see there is a true need. The idea is to work closely with the stakeholders and local authorities so that everyone can be involved in the project. Agir Paulet Cambodge will support this initiative and project. But there is a need of high motivation from local actors, sellers and local authorities. The idea would be to employ local authorities on sensitizing the actors. APLC could supply rubbish bins, it could pay vehicles to collect waste, and provide a small incinerator. But if villagers are not sensitized with the environmental problems, with cleaning issues, and if nobody makes the effort to use the rubbish bins, then the project would be useless. We'll be right back. Today, in terms of interdependent tourism, we launched an identification process for the villagers who would be interested to use their premises and to share a piece of their life with tourists. Many are petitioning, and we want to connect these motivated people with foreigners eager to discover a more traditional aspect of Cambodia that they can live with while going in a city like Siem Reap. The idea is to gather all these motivated actors in a kind of committee in charge to handle the tourist activities, to manage the tourism development in Banteay Chhmar so that economic repercussions could really benefit the population. APLC is here to settle the link between the outside and the village and to launch a dynamics within Banteay Chhmar. It's what's known as interdependent tourism. We want a clever and useful tourism. APLC wants this development to start quickly, counting on the temple attraction, but also on the possibilities of discovering local habits, visiting the weavers' projects and agricultural projects. Thank you.